to the final of the World Test Championship.
Thanks a lot for talking to CNN News 18. It's a pleasure to be speaking to you again after a very long time. We are here talking about the World Test Championship final. Everybody considers India to be the underdogs. Would you agree with that and why?
No, I totally disagree. I think we've played some terrific cricket to get here. And, you just take Australian Tour's example. Almost 10, 11 players were not available. And the guys who were on the bench, they were asked to play, and to the extent where a couple of them were actually practice bowlers, they ended up playing on that tour and they delivered. So that speaks volumes of our strength, how we've been able to, deliver that knockout punch in Brisbane has been truly remarkable. So by no means I would say that, we are underdogs and, yes, we haven't had enough match practice. New Zealand have had the best preparation possibly, two test series before this game. But that's how the game is. So we have to accept what has come our way, and we've prepared to the best of our ability. So I would focus on what one needs to do in the next step, and not worry about what people are thinking or that, because I don't think that's true. That's right.
So you don't believe that India is in any way at disadvantage? Also because we are hearing that the pitch is supposed to have bounce and pace and carry. Will there also not be a disadvantage for India more than New Zealand?
Well, bounce, pace and carry depends how you look at it. I mean, if I was asked to bat on a pitch which had bounce and pace, I would say that means the woodland spot has been reduced for fast bowlers. If they falter on the shorter side, I'm going to get under the ball and play maybe over slips or gully or over point. And if they falter on fuller side, then I have a chance of hitting on the rise. I would say that when the ball starts swinging and seaming around, that is when the problem is. And that problem is for everyone. It's not just for our players. That's a problem for any side in the world. When the ball starts swinging, so pace and bounce, more opportunities to score runs. That is how I look at it. But a little bit of swing, seam movement, we need to be on our toes and stay focused and play a tight game.
Well, that's the challenge in playing in England, isn't it? And India, of course, has done well recently. They will hope to kind of build on the experience that some of them at least have, not all of them have. But I want to ask you, the Indian bowling attack, you talked about the bench strength that India has and has displayed in the Australian series. We are looking at a crop of bowlers that, I don't know whether you agree, we have never really seen. That we can even, not have a Bhuvi in the lineup and really be very confident. What do you make of this bowling attack? And is that India's biggest advantage, difference from previous years as we go into this final?
So, I don't like comparisons. Earlier also we've had some great bowlers. But with this generation, they all are playing together at the same time. So these are all bowlers, they complement each other. Someone like Ishan, who's tall, Bumrah is awkward, Shami is skiddy, Umesh, we've got Siraj. There is variety of fast bowlers that we have. Shardul is there. They're all different to each other. So when you put them together as a package, it's a formidable package. They have been able to deliver and they have been able to work together as a unit. Bharat Arun has been their coach for now 3-4 years. I think he's delivered. He's done a wonderful job for the team.
What would your bowling combination be? We are hearing that India could well go in with two spinners, even in these conditions, even though they can go in with four pacers. Would you also agree with that? Would you put in an Ashwin, who's in the season of a lifetime, having a season of his lifetime, and Jadeja, who's a all-rounder, has done well with the bat in the past in England?
I don't like to give my playing 11 and all, because I'm sitting thousands of miles away from them. Neither have I seen them practice, nor have I seen the practice match. They understand who's bowling well, who's in good rhythm, and who isn't. yes, the advantage here is both spinners, they bat well. They bat well and they can build some serious partnerships. You know, lower down the order, every run matters. And when you have someone who can bat and build those partnerships, it's dangerous. Those runs are invaluable. And when we talk about conditions, then I feel that, you know, in India, spinners get purchased off the surface. But in conditions like England, and especially when you're playing with Duke's ball, if it's well maintained, then you get the spinners get the ball to drift, you know, either away from a batter or towards the batter. And the same case with not just with off spinner, but also with left arm spinner. It depends on how you use the shine. So if a quality spinner is given that ball, he is going to for sure utilize what's there in the air and use that, because it's not just the movement and swing for fast bowlers in the air. A quality spinner will be able to do that in the air as well. There is not much purchase of the surface. So it need not be that an off spinner has to get each batter out inside edge pot at short leg. He could always drift the ball away from a right-hander and get him out in slips. And so is the case with left-arm spinner also. So I would say, you know, maybe 3 and 2 wouldn't be a bad option to go, but I haven't seen the wicket. I haven't heard much about it, except you telling me that there is pace and bounce. But I don't know how much the pitch has been watered. So they continue to do so. Even on the 17th, they would be doing so. So let's wait and see.
Let me talk about a couple of our batters. Rishabh Pant. I really want to hear what you say about Rishabh Pant's batting. What a series he had in Australia. And everybody's going gaga over him, and rightly so. I mean, your thoughts on his batting?
To me, he's an impact player. There was a period when people were criticizing him for his short selection. But that is how he scored runs, and that is how he will continue to score runs. And with experience, he will understand those few deliveries in between where you just need to be a little more patient and see off those couple of overs. And then one can get back to his normal style, which is being extremely aggressive. And I enjoy what I see. He's fearless, he's become more confident, and with time, he's only going to get better and better. We can see that from what he was some time ago and what he is today. He's changed. And then when it comes to his dismissals, they're always going to be to those kind of shots, because he likes to play big shots. And he should not be compared to someone like Pujara, because Pujara's dismissals are going to be of different fashion altogether. Because his way of scoring runs is completely different. And both are equally important. I mean, Pujara is also important for our team. So, I'm giving you two extremes. You know, someone who's cautious and tires out the opposition. And the other guy, lower down the order, he has to attack, get on with the game. And because, he may run out of partners. And he's been able to do that successfully. So, let's understand rather than judging him all the time.
No, absolutely. He has really enthralled everybody. There are already comparisons being made with Adam Gilchrist as a wicketkeeper batsman. You talked about his shot selection and how he gets out. Do you see a side of Sehwag in him?
Yeah, I mean, see, I don't like comparing players. Each player has his own identity. And Rishabh would, in time to come, would like to be known as Rishabh Pant and not number two Adam Gilchrist. So every individual likes his own identity, and that is what Rishabh would also like. And I would judge him for what he has been able to do as an individual without comparing him to anyone else. And the impact that he's had in the last few months has been tremendous. So I hope he continues to improve and get better and better with time.
What about your fellow Mumbaikar, Ajinkya Rahane? How crucial is he? Because, he has shown that he can actually deliver the goods for India, both as a batsman overseas and even as a captain material overseas, as he showed in Australia. So he's grown well beyond his years, and he's somebody that India will really rely on in the match like this.
Well, Ajinkya's batting number is a critical number, number 5. And he did well in Melbourne Test match. He got 100, and that's where the tide changed. From there, we got momentum, and team started playing different brand of cricket on here. He's played crucial knocks after that. He also contributed in Chennai Test match. When we speak about ups and downs, each player goes through that. To speak about his captaincy, he looked very calm. He looked matured. He's a good student of the game. He was able to absorb pressure. He was not overwhelmed by these challenges. And to stay calm and yet be aggressive in his decision-making, because decision-making becomes really critical when you are managing the team on the field. A dressing room, you've got your coach, other players to discuss with, but on the field, spontaneously, you have to take those calls. And he did not falter there. He was quite good there. So overall, Ajinkya as a player has grown.
Can I ask you about the battle of the captains itself? Virat versus King. How do you see this matchup? Who has the edge?
I think it is not about Virat and Kane Williamson. It is about India and New Zealand. And I remember why I'm saying this, because in 1998, when Australians came to India, the series was termed as Warne versus Tendulkar series. And that time also I reminded everyone that, it is not Warne versus Tendulkar. It is Australia versus India. And we've seen that. Like, why I'm saying this is because you see in Australia, a number of players were not there, but the team put their act together and they won. And so was the case with also New Zealand 3-4 days ago when they won the second test. Kane Williamson wasn't there. Along with him, Tim Southee did not play, Jamieson did not play, Watling did not play. A number of guys did not play. And they won the test match because everyone contributed as a team. And that is when the team is going to win. So we speak about Virat and Kane Williamson, extremely important for both sides. But eventually the team which is going to take you through.
How do you approach a match like this, Sachin, where it is not a series? You cannot come back from it. It is a one-time final, which is very rare, of course, in test cricket kind of a format in cricket. We, of course, see this in World Cups, etc. But if you were playing, how would you approach a match like this where you have no second chances, really?
So for this particular finals, now see, you spoke about just one final, one chance. But in T20 or for that matter, 50 over World Cup, there is only one chance. That is only because there is continuity. You only play each opposition once, whichever pool you are in. It only happens once. And then it's fair to play one match in the finals. But here in a test series, we played literally, 4 test matches against Australia, 4 against England and India. And then suddenly you make it to the finals. And then you only play one game. It should have been a WTC series, the final series, best of 3. And then that needs to be decided where you and how you want to play, one home and one away, whatever. But that means all test-playing nations need to keep themselves free during this period. So ICC also must have had their own challenges. And then over a period of time, they will put their heads together and, come up with some newer ideas. That's fine. And as far as approaching this match, I think before the game is what, you have that anxiety. You have a number of people talking around you about this particular game. And that buzz is there. And that is how pressure builds. But you need to just stay calm and absorb everything. And then eventually go out on the field. Give yourself some time. Because it's important to make yourself comfortable there in the middle. So bowlers start bowling well when they are comfortable in the middle. And the batters start playing well when they are comfortable in the middle. Those 22 yards should belong to you. You should look to own those 22 yards. And that doesn't happen instantly. It takes some time. So give yourself a little time to get adjusted to various things happening around you. Because of pandemic, also, the preparations have been different for our team. So give yourself a little more time.
So speaking of the WTC format, I wanted to ask you, just largely speaking about test cricket, we're doing the WTC, we're doing this format, we're doing day and night test matches. Do you think all of this is enough to preserve test cricket? Because as you said, mentioned or alluded to, T20 leagues are kind of taking over the calendar. That's the most predominant format. Do you think this is sufficient or more needs to be done to preserve test cricket?
Well, this is a good move by the ICC, but let's not forget, you know, everyone is getting used to T20 and ODIs also. I mean, they are batsman-dominated formats where, you know, you in ODIs, with the new rules, you score 300 and it's not safe. So the ball continues to stay hard till the end, and that's when you see a lot of runs being scored even right till the end. So what is happening? You are actually teaching spectators to get used to that action in T20 virtually every ball, and in ODI cricket maybe every second over you expect a boundary or a six. But in test cricket, if you don't provide good wickets, and that is where I'm coming, the heart of test cricket is the kind of pitch that you play on. If the pitch is not good, if it's not result oriented, and because I said, you know, there are two formats which are batsman dominated formats. This could be bowler dominated format. This format, where there is some action from bowler's end, you know, if he's beating the bat or putting that pressure on a batter, and batter's technique is tested. So that is something which ICC needs to focus on. There'll be more engagement because if on a flat surface, bowler feels that there is not much I can do, I'm going to bowl defensive lines. The batter feels that bowler cannot get me out because he's already bowling defensive lines. I'm not going to take any undue risk. So if I have to, you know, just play dot balls, it doesn't matter. And spectators don't want to see that because spectators are used to T20 and 50 over format, which is now, you know, full of action. So they want to see action, but this is a different kind of action. Bowlers putting pressure on batters is also kind of action which is possibly missing at times. So it should be slightly tilted towards bowlers in this particular format as far as the pitches are concerned.
Well, absolutely. And that's why test cricket is what it is, because it's the ultimate test of a batsman's ability. And also, of course, bowlers bowling again, you know, over after over. Finally, I want to ask you, Sachin, is there that one thing that you think India needs to be wary of when it comes to facing this Kiwi side? The one thing that comes to your mind?
A good start. Whether you bowl or you bat, the first 2 hours, the first session is going to be important. Because that will lay the foundation. And on that you construct over the next 5 days. You know, so the first session is going to be critical, is what I feel.
Would you have liked to be part of a format like this, the WTC? Do you miss playing?
In time to come, you know, there are going to be multiple things happening. So, you know, I'm comfortable here right now, and I'm watching and enjoying, you know, what is happening around the world in cricket. And I'm looking forward to this game on the 18th. I'm sure it's going to be closely fought because both teams are very well balanced. It's going to be a great contest. We get to watch good cricket, and hopefully on 22nd, we should be all smiling.
Any message for the Indian team? One last message.
All the best. We are all wishing well for you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you.
It was so lovely to speak to you.
Lovely. Thank you so much. You take care, and best wishes to your family.
Thank you. To you too.
See you soon.
India go through the final of the World Test Championship.